Dylan, come and look at this captain. He's frozen. Dude, I already took down the mine, Mr. Captain. It's okay. What is going on, you fantastic Olympians? It is your boy, Greek Gamer, or Nicholas here, coming at you guys with a brand new video. And today, I'm going to be giving Dungy and everybody else a quick rundown of what needs to be fixed in the Crucible. I personally think that there's some stuff that needs to be worked on, and seeing as how we're going to get that Sandbox / Crucible update, in 2 days, I'm hoping that they're not going to listen to what I have to say because I don't have that big of a voice right now, but I hope that at least some of these things come in. That guy got a triple kill with a grenade. I just realized that as I'm recording this, but yeah. First thing, let's talk about Sun Singers. Listen to me, okay? Bungie, if you fix one thing, fix the warlocks. I main a warlock now, and it's stupid broken. I'm sorry, it is. Like, it's terrible. Like, you have Flame Shield, which I'm gonna get to in a minute. You have the Amplify perk on the Stormcaller. The Stormcaller super itself is broken. The Sun Singer. You guys already know my methods on that. I don't know how they would fix the subclass, but I don't think that personally you should be able to self-res in PvP. I think that's stupid. Look at that self-res. You just get melted, as I was saying that. Then I got melted. But what I wanted to talk about was, first off, the Warlocks, like I said. So let's get into the Sunsinger first. First off, the Firebolt Grenade, the DOT damage needs to go down. I'm okay with Viking Funeral and being it tick longer because that makes people stay out of the fight. That's fine. But the fact that you get one shot, literally one shot from any gun in the game, and then grenaded, or grenaded and then one shot by any gun in the game, and you're dead. That's it. That's all. You can't do anything about it. I think they should lower the DOT time like they did with the Thorn. Lower it to about three. Three seems about reasonable. At least you wouldn't be absolute, you know what I mean? Obviously, it wouldn't make a huge difference, but it would help. Or even if you want to, just put it to one, because that fulfills the DOT, keeping people out of the game kind of recovery type deal that the grenade is meant to fulfill. Second of all, I want to talk about the Flame Shield melee. I don't understand why they did this in Inception. It seems like a stupid idea, and in Creation. But I don't get why they don't just make the Flame Shield, and this is my solution for the Flame Shield. Make it so that it's like Force Barrier. You don't get the shield unless you kill someone. That's fair. And make an exotic. That's almost like the, what do you want to call them? I forgot what they're called now. The no backup plans. That's what they're called. The no backup plan gauntlets for the Defender Titan, where it triggers a Force Barrier whenever you get a shotgun kill. You can have an exotic similar to that for the Warlock. That sounds fair, right? I believe that that sounds pretty fair. Next up is the Stormcaller. First off, Bungie, fix your stuff. You don't give a perk to a Warlock. The Warlock has the highest melee range already in the game, and that's a problem within itself, but I don't think they're going to fix the melee range on an entire class, because let's be honest, their jump sucks, so they need something, and their grenades are pretty good, their supers are pretty broken, but we already just covered that with the Sunsinger. But I do believe for a fact that, you know, I don't know how to really explain it, but you guys heard what I said, just get rid of Flame Shield altogether, or make it so you have to kill the person to get the shield, because that's fair. That sounds fair. You shouldn't be able to give you, like, live an entire melee fight and do DOT damage with your melee while getting an over shield. It's absolutely stupid. See, there, Force Bearer. I killed him, and that's why it triggered. But getting into the Stormcaller super as a whole, the range needs to decrease. I think I can formally say that I main a Stormcaller right now, and the range of which you can lightning, you can, like, I don't know, zap people, if you want to call it that, in your Storm Trance, is absolutely stupid. You can do so much with that. The perk Landfall gives you a built-in Fist of Havoc, which is absolutely mental, on top of the fact that it's an amazing broken super, on top of which you can have the Transcendence perk active, which means if you get a grenade and melee charge, when your grenade and melee charge are full, you get a 21 second super. 21 seconds of your super, and that's all running around zapping people. I can't tell you guys how many quad feeds, 5-mans, 6-mans I've gotten with the Stormcaller because of that. It's broken. That's pretty much it at this point. I mean, the Warlock's the only things that really need to be patched. Everything else is in a pretty good place. As for buffs, they can't really fix the Sunbreaker without making it broken again. The Striker is in a good place. The Defender Titan's in a good place. Gunslinger's in a good place. I would like to see a little bit of a longer time for the Gunslinger trance for it to be able to, you know, have more effectiveness in the Crucible. I also think that they should increase the Golden Gun damage in PvP and PvE. Well, mostly in PvE for obvious reasons. And the Night Stalker's in a good place as well. But that's pretty much my fixes for the Crucible and Destiny. I'll talk to you guys in the next video. This has been your boy, Greek Gamer, signing off. Peace out, you Olympians. By the way, we're almost at 200 subs. Don't forget to subscribe. Just gotta fit that in there. Shameless advertising.